who do not forgive, who do not forget, expect us.
Greetings, citizens of a manufactured reality. What could possibly be on your mind today? Thoughts of your own? Thoughts can be beamed into your head.
They're fully admitting now that they have technology which can transmit audio directly into your ears from a distance without anyone else around you knowing that it's happening to you. So they can put voices in your head, and they're admitting it now.
But in smaller spaces and within cities, this opens up the possibility to use lasers on people in the open and to basically be dropping little words on their ears.
This technology works in reverse. You can't translate Latin into English and not be able to translate English into Latin. Your mind can be read, thought can be inserted, and with light patterns, memory can be wiped.
Which is great. But the fact that we are getting better at erasing memories also has some scary implications. The lead scientist on the project admits the technique raises ethical questions, saying that messing around with a person's memories like this could affect the person's thinking in general, and also might accidentally erase other memories. Even scarier, though, is that this study is hardly the first of its kind. Researchers have been playing around with memory erasure for years, and have already figured out how to not only delete them in various ways, they've also figured out how to implant new memories.
We've shown that with the right technology, these people's thoughts could be decoded and understood by any listener. To do this, the research team asked 5 epilepsy patients who were already undergoing brain surgery to help.
Thought control and memory control are the end game of dystopian network Palantir, working with the NGA and D-Wave AI for the next generation in pre-crime surveillance with Birigo Technologies and HB Gary as a collective known as Team Themis. Team Themis is backed by Osamunata, Singapore venture capitalist founding K2, backed by a round table of Asian billionaires. Its first investor was, of course, the CIA. Everything about Palantir is kept secretive, including these days its founder Peter Thiel, who travels with body doubles.
And the one thing I'm finding about Mr. Peter Thiel is they don't all seem to be the same person. For example, this Peter Thiel doesn't have a chin dimple or a blemish on the side of his nose, but this Peter Thiel has a blemish and a chin dimple. Right? Like, this Peter Thiel, no chin dimple. This Peter Thiel, chin dimple. These actually look like completely different people, you know, with nose bridges and stuff. So, what I'm suspecting is the way that Mr. Thiel might have been able to pass his security clearance as he's got.
Palantir's Gotham is the specific distro used on you.
Help decision makers. Palantir quickly integrated many vital data sources into a single, comprehensive view. This data included live satellite tracking of aid workers, reports and aid requests sent by workers using mobile devices, reporting from media agencies and governments, imagery from airborne quadcopters, real-time weather updates, and the location of key relief infrastructure and resources.
Whereas Palantir Metropolis is the distro used to game the economy.
The name Palantir is also a Lord of the Rings reference. It refers to a magical seeing stone that lets you see what's happening in the faraway lands, which I think's kind of fitting for what they do with big data crunching. And I didn't know, like, so I, you know, working with the NSA and FBI at the federal level is a big thing, but working with local law enforcement agency, that's something that, you know, we kind of talked about last time, but now it's just even more evident.
They make software for hedge funds, banks, and financial service firms.
The term Palantir is lifted from fiction as Saruman's eye.
I see you. There is no life in the void. Only
and Palantir, aside from seeing you directly through any wall via the eyes in the sky and ground correcting telemetry, also sees every single digital interaction. It is today the basis of the United States intelligence community.
To your technologies, and right here's an illustration of some of the way they analyze data. It's got keywords and connections everywhere, supposedly how elections relate to the birth rate, to the explosion of population, to different types of negative events here, assassinations, their connection with public appearance, the Taliban, the connections to financing, to hijacking, to drug dealing, to our Chamber of Commerce, to Bank of America.
So let's take all this predictive technology and couple it with being able to listen to, insert and erase memory. Now you truly have people playing God, without permission. We are not Jesus. Nor do we have Alzheimer's. Expect us.
Last night I dreamt about how things were.
Not here yet! Of every enemy of the state!
And then I woke up here.
The moral to be drawn from this dangerous nightmare situation is a simple one. Don't let it happen. It depends on you.